that question. That's a good point. So it really was a fusion of cultures, immigrants and Native Americans on the dance floor. Thank you for that.
Tell me real quick again what the difference between clogging, flat foot, and buck dancing, especially for those people that came in later. So the clogging is more lifting the knee.
Clogging tends to be choreographed dancing with their basic step involved a 4-inch shuffle, and there's a certain cadence that's kept throughout the music. And they're often done in a choreographed team approach, and they're really about dance. It's about dance, the show. Whereas flatfooting tends to be this basic walking step. It's mostly done, like buck dancing, mostly done without any choreography. It's all done based on improvisation. And buck dancing tends to be done in tap shoes, and it tends to involve more of these heel steps where they drop the heel and show the toe. You won't see a flat footer really doing that and call themselves buffer. Although there are people who do this and call themselves buck dancer. They only do it when really a flat footer's walking step. There's a lot of overlap in the terminology, and it's not really that important. It's all clogging, actually, to me. But there's a kind of pre-modern clogging that's proposed. So Appalachian clogging, that was from the 1800s, and that is not that precision choreography, and it is really they all come together earlier on to have a career. Do you agree with that?
The clogging actually was when Baskin Lunsford took the SoCal Gap dancers. These were people from Haywood County, North Carolina.
What year was that?
I think it was like 1927.
Yeah, so clogging as a modern form, this guy Baskin
Lunsford, yeah.
Modernized.
Well, he brought this team to the White House to dance for the King and Queen of England, and as part of the folk life stuff. And the Queen of England, who actually is who named it clogging.
Oh, right.
She actually said, well, that reminds us of our clogging at home. Because they were doing that, the precision steps, because that was the team that started all that.
Because there's a good YouTube of like this kind of Baskin Lunsford and the early cloggers, and you can see their distinctive forward double toe step in unison. It creates this monstrous sound. It's really, you can't even hear the music anymore.
Right, it
popularized
it and killed it at the same time, as far as I'm concerned. It's like a lot of stuff. It popularized the dance, so a lot more people were aware of it.
Yeah.
But it killed it for the home folks.
Because it was a back porch dance art form. It was something people did on their porch to people when they didn't, before they had radio. That was what they would do, and it would add music, it was how they had fun. But it was a back porch art form.
And it's the same with the music. I mean, that's why bluegrass music is a continuation of the old traditional music. But the bluegrass music, the real difference is the old-time players, and there's modern old-time now, we won't get into this, but the old-time music, the old traditional music, you would get out of the way of the tune. You would learn a tune from a person, and you would do your best to reproduce that. In bluegrass music, it became my performance.
Yeah, show, it's all that
and
show.
And so now everybody wants
exhibition.
To do variations and to make it for an audience, as opposed to sitting on the porch for 6 hours
they
playing.
They killed it, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, it's just a different thing, but
this is not bluegrass.
It's a blessing, it's all a blessing and a curse.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's not just for old-time music.
Sometimes, yeah,
some
we
of
do,
it,
yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, because somebody asked me, is it bluegrass? And I said, well, no, it's not bluegrass, and I call it mountain music.
That's good, but bluegrass is also mountain music. It's pre-bluegrass.
It's not pre-bluegrass, mountain music.
No, it's not. It's bluegrass is very different. I mean, there's a lot of differences.
Let's go out with a bang. Can we go back to detuning?
Yeah.
We're going to do that. Too Young to Marry. It's going to be our last song. Okay. No jokes about it.
If I
have. Yeah, you can. I'll mention that Mick Kinney is part of the Georgia Crackers, and they are performing today at 4 o'clock on the main stage. It's free. It's the best Georgia string band music there is, and it's sort of like when you talk about Deep South music, it is the best. Every chance they play, I go hear them and often dance with them. I love Georgia Cracker. It would be a shame to come to a traditional music festival and not hear them play. And they have new CDs which would be for sale at their concert. Mick Kinney is also a music teacher in the greater Atlanta area. And if you want you or your kids to have lessons, he taught me banjo. He can teach guitar, fiddle, what else? Everything. And he'll come to your home and teach you, and it's very, very convenient.
I do residencies.
And John, why don't you say, well, you can get some CDs later?
Oh, yeah, I just thought of, you know, get some gas money. If anybody's interested, I've got lots of CDs and books and stuff. I've got a few with me.
His CD with Bruce Green, it's like amazing.
Yeah, oftentimes I play with just fiddle and dulcimer.
I've been
playing with that fiddle for 30 years.
I have a YouTube of me dancing to your Yellow Barber. When I just started dancing in my first year, I made a YouTube. And it's fast. It is fast.
Really?
Yeah. And, and it's very popular. You and Bruce Green.
Oh.
I guess I should pay the royalty.
No, I don't know. I'm just curious. We hardly ever play that tune together.
Really?
We must have just gotten in the mood.
It's on your CD. I just recorded my feet. All you see is my feet dancing.
Oh,
it's very popular.
On the CD. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's actually.
It's a YouTube from
the
CD playing
back. Oh, well,
it's
Yellow Barber,
it's
very fast.
I have my YouTube channel on it.
Yeah, that was my first
and free dance lessons on it. That's my friend. Get out and dance, everyone. That's my message. It's free and it's healthy.